Hi, my name is Jacob. Keeping your wireless internet signal secure is one of the most important things you should do. Unsecured Wi-Fi means anyone can use it, so I'm going to show you how to set up your Wi-Fi and router security. This is a general walkthrough of how most routers are set up. Keep in mind that this information may differ from manufacturer to manufacturer, but this guide will be a good start. To begin, make sure your modem and router are both off. Remove the power from both devices if they're already powered on. Next, connect the modem to the WAN or internet port on your router with an Ethernet cable. In some cases, these are a different color to make it easier to identify the correct port. Connect your laptop or computer to port 1 on the router. This step will make the initial setup much easier in a lot of cases. If you don't have a device with an Ethernet port, you may be able to set up the router over Wi-Fi. We'll talk more about that later. Now return power to your modem and router. And that's it for the hardware configuration. Now it's time to configure your router. Begin by checking the documentation that came with the router. In most cases, you'll be directed to open a web browser, such as Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, and then type a specific IP address or web address into the address bar. If you don't have access to a computer with an Ethernet port, such as a MacBook Air, check the technical details info sticker, usually on the bottom of the router, and look for a default Wi-Fi network name and password. Once connected over Wi-Fi, you can then launch a web browser and access the router setup wizard by web address or IP address. The setup wizard will usually have you configure the administrator password for the router. This is the password you'll need if you want to log back into the router in the future and make changes. Setting it will also prevent intruders from getting in using widely known default passwords. If you forget this password, you'll have to factory reset the router and go through the setup process again from scratch. So always write it down in a safe place. Not a big deal, but consider yourself warned. Your network name is also known as SSID. This is going to be the name of your Wi-Fi network. In most cases, this name is broadcast to allow devices to see your network. Don't worry, as long as you secure your network with a password, which we'll cover in the next step, you're not giving free internet to your neighborhood. Some folks really get creative when they name their network, such as Pretty Fly for Wi-Fi, Bill Y the Science Fi, or Virus Distribution Center. You get the idea. No matter how you name your network, the next step, securing it, is the most important part. If your router is dual band, meaning it has two Wi-Fi networks, one at 2.4 GHz and another at 5 GHz, we strongly recommend that the two networks do not share the same name. This can lead to issues with the connection appearing to drop or stutter. Simply adding 5G to the end of the 5 GHz network can avoid this. Now it's time to set your Wi-Fi password. Your Wi-Fi password may be referred to by a number of names. Passphrase, security key, and pre-shared key are common. Generally, you want to create a password that's 8 to 16 characters long and contains both upper and lowercase letters and at least one number. Once you've done these steps, you'll be prompted to save your settings. Remember, you'll have to configure your computers and devices to connect to your new router. Depending on what you're doing, this may mean updating the password on each or connecting it for the first time. By following these steps, you should now have a safe and secure access point that lets you and your family connect to the internet. Remember, if you're having issues with your internet connection, don't hesitate to call us or visit Start.ca to send us an email. Thank you for watching. Check out our other videos, subscribe, and keep up with the latest from Start.ca.